Everybody bought little buttons and waved flags and sang songs. There was no feeling of despair about it at all.
England couldn't possibly lose. No matter how many Germans pushed how many Englishmen into the Channel, they'd get no further. We couldn't possibly lose.
We were brought up to think that one Englishman was worth 10 Germans.
I thought that any enemy of England was an enemy of mine, and I wanted to be in it.
Oh, 6 months or 12 months, it'd be all over, and Bob's your uncle.
Yeah, I went with a friend of mine into Shepherd's Bush Empire to see the picture show there, and they showed the fleet sailing the high seas and played Britons Never Shall Be Slaves. And you know, one feels that little shiver run up their back, and you know you've got to do something.
A friend of mine said to me, we're going to join up. It was from the patriotic point of view and from the general excitement of the whole affair, I suppose.
I didn't believe in war to that extent, but I was prepared to do my part.
You see, in those days, men weren't to think for themselves. They just had to do what they were told, and that's all there was to it.
Oh, my mother was very aggrieved about it. But, you know, a young man, you decide you're going to go.
At lunchtime, I left the office, went along to Armory House, and there was a queue of about 1,000 people trying to enlist.
Everybody thought that it would be a civilized war and wanted to be fit enough to go.
Two of us decided to join up together, and when we told the boss we were going to start training on Monday, he was very annoyed. He didn't make any promise at all that our jobs would be there when we got back.
My mother, she said, you wait until you're 19. See, that was the age in those days, 19 to 35. Well, it was supposed to be.
We were all lads together, you know, full of excitement and all this kind of thing. I mean, I just wanted to have a go at Jerry.
I just thought that I'd like to go and fight for the country. This was the thing. You were proud of your country and you'd do the best you could for it. And this was what most of the young people thought of doing in those days.
My mother, she said to me, look, we could stop you doing this because of your age. I said, yes, I know you could, Mother, but I'm sure you won't, which they never did.
I just felt that all the young fellows of that age were volunteering, and I thought it was my job to do the same.
I was desperately keen, and a whole heap I was aware. I said, direct enlistment, please. They were highly delighted and pushed me in as quick as lightning.
Lots of the lads were joining the local regiments, like the Bucks and the Middlesex. Lads that I knew and been to school with, played football and cricket with. We joined up, hoping for the best.
We were good friends, comrades, and it was a relief from rather boring jobs at home, you see.
I was walking down the Camden Town High Street when two young ladies approached me. Why aren't you in the army? I said, I'm only 17. Oh, they all say that here. And to my amazement, she put her hand in her bag, and I put my hand up to sort of safeguard myself when this white feather finished up my nose.
As we marched to the station, some of the chaps had bowler hats, some had straw hats, some had the regulation peak army cap. Some would have tunics, some would be dressed with their ordinary jackets, with a pair of army trousers. Some had army boots, some didn't. And we really were a motley throng.